to Cape Melville National Park for part of the recognition expeditions and the 1899 Pearl disaster. We're going up there to see some traditional owners who are waiting there for us and some people from the Queensland Parks and Wildlife, and we expect to take 4 or 5 hours to get there from here, just leaving Hopevale this morning. So we'll take some good footage for you on the way and see you at the other end. Just come to the junction here. We could go to Bathurst Heads there. It's 45 k's to the north, which is Princess Charlotte Bay. But we're heading to Bathurst Bay in Cape Melville, where the traditional owners are waiting for us. We've got a good few days there of work to do and some filming and some storying with these guys. So we'll keep going on the track. We've only got a 45 or so k's to go to the Wakuka station, the old ruins, and then after that we'll head out to Wangai campground and Bathurst Bay. Righto.
Lay me down the sacred ground, keep me from the cold, wrap me in the deep warm mud, where the stars can see my soul. Take me where them trees stand tall, by the waters in the river bend. Let me face the rising sun.
That's the road to Ninian Bay, or where we'd go to Barrow Point there. We're not going there today though, we're going to go straight ahead. We're not too far away now from Cape Melville, so Barrow Point was one significant spot with the cyclone. Cape Melville is obviously where we're going to see the monument, and Bathurst Bay, and then Princess Charlotte Bay down the north there. Alright, let's go.
Where the fragrance of the western wind, carried from every springtime flower. Give me peace and give me rest, lay me down on the mountain crest, bury me softly without a sound, let the scrub grow back across that mound, make no monuments of mortal ground, so speak my name again when you lay me down.
We're just coming into Bathurst Bay now on the beach. Crocodile camp. As you can see, it's beautiful glassy water. Nice long beach. We just got to go up to the next campground, the Wangai campground, where the traditional owners are, and go and say g'day and get ready to have a bit of a yarn about the 1899 pearling disaster, the Hurricane Mahina. And, see what stories we can tell.
Mortal memories are all we keep, yeah. Make no monument to mortal crown, don't speak my name again when you lay me down. Ooh. atomic maze. Give me water, give me fire. Don't give me monuments of stone. Give me rainbows in the sky. Give me back my land in which to lie. Make no monuments of mortal ground. Don't speak my name again.
Sometimes, because you know that along this beach there's 300 bodies buried somewhere. Could be just where we're driving right now. They would have washed up on the beach all through here. So beautiful beach, but lonely place to be. Lonely place to be buried. There's no markers. There's no record of where they buried. We just know they were washed up here. They were in their pearling fleets out here. And somber reminder that this guy's been forgotten for a long time. No markers, no names. So, something will fix that.
Alfred Outridge's original site of his grave. It's not where he is now, but he was here somewhere on the foreshore, and he was then moved inland. We can tell that by some old photographs in 1899 of the boulder rocks at the head there and some other boulder rocks at the top here. Righto, it's probably one of those times where we should acknowledge the forgotten crew, the coloured crew. What we're going to do, we've got a cross here made out of the timbers from our lugger Antonia. And boys at the yard made that. On the side, we've got a pandanus mat burning, a woven mat, which for us represents, you know, the life of an islander and a Torres Strait Islander or a South Sea Islander. You're born on the mat, you eat in the mat and sleep in the mat and live on the mat, and when you die, you're buried with the mat. On the front, we've got the names of all the so-called coloured crew. The South Sea Islanders, Malaysians, Filipinos, people from Singapore, 81 Japanese. There's 9 Torres Strait Islanders, Aboriginals, New Zealand, people from Java and Ceylon, India, even 3 Egyptians. This is one of our probably small ways of just starting that recognition process. What we're going to do is take this wooden cross up to the monument and put it beside there temporarily, just for the day. We won't leave it here, of course. It's timber. Next bushfire will be gone. And also, being a national park, we need to put a more permanent memorial following getting permission from both the traditional owners and the park, but needed to happen, so it's going to go up there anyway. We'll take some photos and read out all the names and start giving some closure. Righto.
Ah, I'm coming down from old Black Mountain, where the air is dark and cold. Promise love in all its glory, where you tried to steal my soul. I walked on and got the feeling of bones buried beneath my feet, and I cried for those forgotten in the blackness and the sleep. I'm coming down from old Black Mountain.
Well, here it is, the monument in memory of the Pearlers lost in the dreadful hurricane on 5th of March 1899. Alfred St. John Outridge, interred here, age 39. He's the one that was buried down the beach there, and he was reinterred here by the family 3 months later. Harold Arthur Outridge, his nephew, age 23, from the Sagita. Edward Charles Athow, age 20, from the Silvery Wave. And got a Bible reading there, when thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee. 43 Isaiah, verses 2. Also, E. Jefferson, Jack Nicholas, Rick Cameron, Murray, Furman, Lee, Carr and Crowley, they were from the lightship that sank. And then the little paragraph at the bottom, what we've been talking about all along, the 15 vessels wrecked and foundered and over 300 coloured men drowned. The blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanseth us from all sin. One of those things, now that we've got those 300 names and where they come from, it's time to recognise them and do something about it. It's been here since 6th of July 1899, so it's been here a while now. Back in the day, they put this monument there referring to the 300 coloured crew in the bottom of the memorial. Been a bit nameless and unrecognised for all that time, so this cross signifies all those names. You've got the South Sea Islander names, there's 41 of those. Japanese, 81 of those. You've got Torres Strait Islanders, there's only 9 of those, but 2 of those are babies, age 1 and 2. Got Aboriginal people from Bathurst Bay here, and Cape Melville, and Java, and Philippines. You've got the Guevaras, the Armats, the Dulas from Malaysia and Singapore. We've even got 3 Egyptians. You've got 11 unknowns. Borneo, Siam, Batavia. Anyway, they're not nameless anymore. But unfortunately, we can't leave this one here. The bushfires or something else will grab it. But we'll take it home with us in the view to putting something more temporary here, more permanent here, rather than this temporary structure. Alfred Outridge was actually moved here, reinterred here on the 6th of July, where this monument was actually installed. He was actually washed up on the beach down there, where his original gravesite was, which we showed you before. But when they moved him up here, it was because he was so close to the beach. And the natives here, or the Aboriginal people at the time, they actually buried him where he lay on that beach, which was very close to the foreshore. And it occurred to me that when I read that he actually washed up on the shore about 4 or 5 days later, after the cyclone, that and many other people did as well, But during the cyclone itself, it washed people and debris and vessels half a K inland. So whilst we're here with Alfred Outridge, who's the only known grave site that we actually know about, the rest are unknown. It could be very possible that down below us here on the flats, even up on some of these hills here, are also some of these guys, not just all along the beach. And it's probably one of those things we'll never know. One of the stories that we heard about Alfred was that he was found up, washed up on the beach, and when they went back to get him, he'd been washed out again to sea. I think it was just lucky that he came back again, so goodness knows how many people went that way. And all in all, apart from 11 unknowns, they've now got a name, they've now got a culture, and they've now got some recognition to the 300 coloured men. I should also say it's not just men, it's women and two babies.
Mahina is standing on the shore. In her heart, she knows he'll come no more. Hurling luggers sailing in a line. Tribute to a diver left behind. Full fathom fires, a lover does lie in the deep, endless ocean. Where seabirds cry, salty tears never dry.